All right.
Let me get back down here. And let's try to finish our little fella up if we can.
It's beautiful out here today in Texas. We've got a nice day.
All right, let me look. Here we go.
Nice day out here. We're enjoying ourselves. Okay, now what we have here is just kind of getting the back here. Now let's go ahead and draw our pants are going to be somewhere up around here. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and cut a thing right here, and we're going to put our pants right there. And of course we want to run our pants, our cut on our pants all the way up here. We're not going to put a crouch area on the little boy. Not that a little boy don't have a crouch area. It's just that we're just going to go ahead and make the pants come all the way to the top. And let's go ahead and start on our shoes. Just kind of bring our legs back here, and we're going to come back here and we're going to make a cut, and we're going to separate that, and that will be the back of our pants back here. Now we'll have to kind of come up, and let's go ahead and make our cut on our pants legs between our shoes. There we go. Make our cut on our pants legs. And shape our shoes just a little bit. Look at that, see? See, when you start to put the detail into the person, that's when you really begin to see the detail that you go. There's the little shirt there. And so let's go ahead and work on this arm. Now we're going to bring this arm just a little bit back some more, and then we're going to kind of let's go ahead and separate our hand here. Okay, let's get that separated just for a minute, and then we're going to kind of do this, bring this up a little bit, and we're going to kind of bring that arm back a little bit. Okay, just a little. We sort of, now of course it's way too thick, so that's going to have to be brought down. The little arm, see how I flip the knife like this to kind of, and you see, look, now you've got your little arm there, and then there's your little hand. And we're gonna kind of do this. Now on a little boy, his arm would not be thick, so we're just going to kind of bring this like this. He would not have a, because he's a little boy, wouldn't have a thick arm unless he was a little heavy set little boy, and that's not what we're going to make him, because the Amish kids are not heavy set. Very often do you ever see an Amish child that is heavy set because of the way they eat. They don't eat, I understand they eat what they grow, so they don't eat a lot of candy and stuff like that. So most of them. Okay, as we see from the back now, it's just kind of, okay, now he's really beginning to have I'm going to come back here and I'm going to cut where his hair is going to be. Just right back here like that. Okay, now naturally we're going to take this and kind of bring this forward, because the hand would be a little bit forward. See, where the arm comes sort of around. You want to be careful now, because it is thin, and it is can be broken easy. Okay. All right. Now, what we want to do is we want to kind of just bring this arm, and like I said, be careful, because you want to get your get everything kind of straight here. You don't want you don't want to put too much pressure on your arm in there. And I'm going to bring that down a little bit more. Super glue does work good. Works real good. Let me tell you something about super glue. When I worked in the bearing business, that's bearing, you know, like ball bearing business, in other words, way back in the 70s, we didn't have super glue. We didn't have super glue at all. And at that time, it was called Loctite. And they still make Loctite items. But Loctite at that time was used for industrial purposes. And it was used, the super glue that you now get today was actually... they first came out to industrial use by O-rings. You could take an O-ring that had been broken, or you could make your own O-rings. Those of you that know what an O-ring is, and they made. We had super glue, but it was called Loctite back then, and it would. They can make O-rings with it. By the rubber, it would just hold like everything in the world. And that's when super glue, I first was introduced to super glue. And I think super glue's really been around for a long time, but it was basically used in industrial use. Okay, look at this. We're getting him now. Now, here we go. It was basically used in industrial use, and it was pretty amazing stuff at that time. Now you know, now we use it all the time, but it was pretty amazing the way it we were just amazed at how it grabbed and kept so quickly. In other words, because at that time we didn't really have glues that were would you know, keep something that quick. And an incident happened. Was not to me, it was not a funny incident. It was an incident that happened. I never forgot that we had a secretary. Okay, now we're gonna just take this hand and just put it down like that, and then we'll put the we'll take the V tool and do it. And one of the incidences that they did, one of the guys, we had a secretary working there, and she was sort of, well, she was sort of a loose lady, as we might possibly say. And they didn't know this was going to happen, but they took that super glue and they put it on her toilet seat. And she sat down. When she got ready to get up, she couldn't get up. It was tearing her skin off. And the guys didn't know this was going to happen. In other words, I didn't participate in this, because it's just, that's horrible. And she stuck to that toilet seat, and I never forgot that. She finally had to, we were going to try to, we had some stuff. At that time, they had some stuff you could put on it that would loosen it. So they tried that, and she was so embarrassed. No, where she just went ahead and got up and took part of the skin off, and she was off for several days. And some guys almost got fired for that. That was not a pleasant thing. But that stuff at that time was amazing. But they had an antidote for it. They had okay. Now, right now we're doing well. We're doing real well. And we've got our little guy. Now, what we have to do is do this hand here. Okay, we want to be real careful as we cut this hand. Okay? Because that is very, very... and I'm going to do it like this. See how I put my hand behind here? And we're going to kind of come around like this, bring that hand where he sort of, okay. And then let's come to the back here and cut. And let's cut down on both sides. We want to be real careful, because this is really getting thin in here. Just like that. And then we want to cut down this in here. And of course we want to There we go. Just like that. See? We want to be careful beneath here. Okay. Now, let's go on and go ahead and get this kind of in the back and all that stuff, kind of get this The reason the little boy is just kind of taking just as long is because he's smaller and we want to be very careful. You saw what happened to the hat. See how it can break on the hat. But this is the Okay, we've got him now. We're doing real well. Just want to get a little bit of that done in there where his little face comes out. All right, I want to get my V tool. I'm going to be very, very careful with this. Alright, now I'm going to take the V-tool and just kind of go around the hair in here. Be careful now. Don't put a lot of pressure on it because this is very, very thin in here. Okay, and that's kind of the kind of come down here where the hair is. And we're just going to kind of get the saw marks off. We'll clean it up and I'll come back. Oh, we got to put the little hands on. We go. And you want to be real, real careful here when you put the hands on. Because see how I got have my finger against that thing? So I don't put a lot of pressure and break anything. See? And I'm going to put them on the inside of it too. Okay. Just sort of like that. So the little boy, as he you'll see, he puts his arm around his little sister as he's standing there with her. Okay, well, let me go and get him, wet him, and we'll get back.